A numeric frequency distribution is one of the many tools that we use to organize and to describe numeric or quantitative data. In this instance, we've been given 15 data points and we've been asked to create a numeric frequency distribution with four intervals, whereafter we'll then draw the histogram to graphically depict this numeric frequency distribution. In order to determine how wide these intervals should be, we need to calculate the range first. The range of the data is the largest data value in the data set minus the smallest data value in the data set. At this point, you'll realize that it's really important to order your data before you start the exercise so that you are certain that you choose the correct data values for the largest data value and the smallest data value. So in this instance, 40 is our largest data value and 1 is our smallest data value. So we plug that into our formula, we get 40 minus 1, that gives us 39. Once we have our range, we can calculate the interval width, which is the range divided by the number of intervals. So over here, we've been given the number of intervals as 4. So that'll be 39 divided by 4. That gives us 9.75. And to make sure all our data values are included into our intervals, we need to round up this figure to 10. So our frequency distribution on the right here will then have the intervals, a tally if you wish to tally the data values, and the frequency. In other words, how many data values lies within each one of the intervals. So we start our interval with the smallest data value, which is 10, and then we include 10 units in this interval because our width here is 10. So our interval will then be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So those are 10 units from 1 to 10. The next interval then needs to start at the number after 10, which is 11. And if we include 10 units in this interval is 10 to 20. The next one will be 21 to 30. And the last one will be 31 to 40. So over here, you can see that we've got 4 intervals. Okay, so if we now tally this data, we can see which data values are included in the first interval. It's 1, 2, 8, and 9. Our next interval is 14, 14, 15, and 16. Our next interval is 23 and 25. Our last interval is 31, 33, 34, 36, and 40. That gives us 4, 4, 2, and 5. And if you add this up, you should get the number of observations, which is 15. So we know that our intervals look like this. It was 1 to 10, 11 to 20, 21 to 30, and 31 to 40. And our frequencies were as follows. It was 4, 4, 2, and 5. So on the y-axis of our histogram, we'll include the frequencies, and at the bottom here, we'll have our intervals. So an interval will usually have a name. If these are age brackets, you will include age at the bottom here, or if it's time in minutes, you'll include time, or whatever the context of the exercise was. In this instance, we have no context, just numbers, so we just call it intervals. Our highest frequency is 5, so we'll number these frequencies as follows, and then we can draw those intervals onto this graph. So the first interval, which is 1 to 10, has a frequency of 4. The next one is 11 to 20, that is also 4. The next one is 21 to 30, that has a frequency of 2. And the last one is 31 to 40, that has a frequency of 5.